Posted by u/redwings. When did a game of hide and seek go horribly wrong? When I was about 8 years old, my little brother who was 6 at the time and my little sister who was 3 years old were playing some type of easy hide and seek in my grandparents' backyard. Well, there are woods behind their house. Our sister, being a defiant toddler, ran into the woods and my brother just saw her run in and ran in after her. They were in the woods for hours because she ran in so deep and they both got turned around. Our brother found a hunting post, climbed up it into the tree, and found a way out. They then knocked on doors, covered in dirt and scratched up, until someone answered. A woman gave them a ride back because our brother was able to point out landmarks to get back to our grandmother's house. They got back while my mother was on the phone with the cops. They were discussing a helicopter to find them. We were this close to a search party. They walked a collective 2 to 3 miles. They could have gone miles deeper into rural woods if they didn't keep going one way and find the post. So yeah, watch your damn kids, lol. Telling them don't go into the woods does not guarantee they will listen. Edit, I misused Amber Alert, but we were very close to a search party. Also, the police were called and still showed up to give the kids a talking to. Nothing was learned and we were repeatedly locked outside on nice days with woods behind our own house. I managed to send an entire store on lockdown and freak out my entire family when I was maybe 5 years old. My family was at Lowe's, and I decided to take my Kirby plushie with me and hide behind some shelves or boxes, and see if they could find me. Turns out they couldn't, and ran around outside because they thought someone kidnapped me. The entire store went on lockdown for a missing child, all the while I'm sitting, giggling and waiting for them to find me. I eventually came out of hiding after my mom passed me, and got in huge trouble afterwards. I never hid in public again as a kid. From the great British actor David Niven's Wikipedia page. While on leave in 1940, Niven met Primula Primi Susan Rollo, February 18, 1918, London, May 21, 1946. Primi died at the age of 28, only 6 weeks after the family moved to the US. She fractured her skull in an accidental fall in the Beverly Hills, California home of Tyrone Power, while playing a game of hide and seek. She had walked through a door believing it to be a closet, but instead, it led to a stone staircase to the basement. I was a waiter and some kids from a party I was serving played hide and seek, and about 5 minutes later they had to come back because the chef came to cook, teppanyaki restaurant. There were two guardians looking after the children and one of them realized that a child was missing and freaked out. It was like a mini manhunt in the restaurant. This was all done by the guardians since they didn't tell anyone. I just overheard them and decided to watch what they would do. After about 5 to 10 minutes of searching, the girl comes out crying. They forgot about me. She was in the bathroom the whole time and she was quiet when they called for her because she thought they were still playing. We had just recently moved into our neighborhood and my sister, 5 at the time, was playing hide and seek with the neighbor kid. Long story short, kid couldn't find her. All the adults started going around the neighborhood shouting for her. It was getting dark. After a while, my parents called the police. Someone eventually found her and she said she did hear everyone looking for her, but she was playing hide and seek so duh she wasn't coming out until someone found her. Parents called the police back and told them not to come. That's how we met most of our neighbors. Edit, since lots of people are asking, she apparently wasn't even hiding well. She told me she was in front of the neighbor's garage, not even in nor behind. She is much smarter these days, but still very stubborn. Before I was born, my brothers and sisters played a game at my aunt's house down by the river. My eldest brother decided to hang by his fingertips inside the water well. Meanwhile, and unknowing of that fact, my other brother thought about hiding up inside the little steeple cover of the well, and to get to it needed to slam shut the well cover. Lamau. Slam. Blood-curdling scream. Splash. Cries for help. Between fits of unadulterated anger interspersed with disbelief and worry, my aunt, grandmother and mom managed to get him pulled up, which wasn't easy because with all of those smashed fingers of his, he couldn't hold tight to a rope. So when I was a wee kid and a scout, we played hide and seek in the dark. We usually played something like this every time the last 15 minutes. It was a medium-sized cabin, essentially. There was a lot of places to hide, lots of stuff just lying around. For some reason there was a coffin there and nobody, as far as I know, ever hid inside. Because it's a coffin, and that's just creepy. But my smart ass hid inside it. Unlucky for me, another kid also looking for a hiding spot saw me. He decided to lock the coffin I was inside of. Yeah, I had claustrophobia for quite a while afterwards. Peas. I have an intense hatred of the name Marcus since because that was the bastard's name. Oh, I have a good one. Didn't happen to me, but a friend of mine, but I was in that game of hide and seek. Here I go. When I was 8, I was at a birthday party of my neighbor's daughter. We had mutual friends, and one of them, let's call him Toby, wasn't really the brightest, we all weren't. But he took the cake, like eating a dead wasp once and then wondering why his mouth was swollen. Anyway, the daughter then all challenged us to a game of hide and seek. For context, they lived on a farm which wasn't the smallest, so there was plenty of space to hide. But to not draw this game too lengthy, we all agreed to only hide in the barn and on the main plot, and not the meadow behind it. It only took the daughter about 15 minutes to find me and the other kids invited to the party, except for said Mr. Darkhead Toby. After about half an hour of searching for him, we started to get concerned. By this time, it was about 5:30 p.m. and we were all getting ready to go home, but Toby was nowhere to be found. Our parents agreed to let us stay until 7 p.m, hoping that he was found till then. After Toby wasn't found, Toby's parents called the cops and a search squad was sent out. Still no sign of him, the cops gave up. The next morning, I woke up to my parents telling me, in a tone of relief, that Toby was found. Apparently what happened was that Toby somewhat got lost on said meadow and was only found 8 hours later standing on the side of a road that was 4 miles away, with his shorts and t-shirt all ripped and damaged. He was only found after a relative spotted him with his headlights. Oh, did I mention that Toby was new to the area and didn't know where what was? We are still friends to this day, 18 years later, and whenever we are drunk or really bored, we bring this story up and just laugh our guts out about it. About him not being very bright, yeah, he now has his master's degree in mechanical engineering. So glad this story ended well, or else my life would be different now. Not exactly horribly wrong if you ask me. But when I was younger, like about 3 or so, my great-grandmother was watching my younger brother, some cousins, and I. She decided hide-and-seek was a great idea since we all weren't able to open any doors without her help. Well, I found this perfect spot tucked between the wall and a couch with a small coffee table between the arm of the couch and that wall. So I got under the coffee table. Well, I got too comfy and I fell asleep. Back then I was a hard sleeper. My great-grandma gets so worried that I somehow got out of the house when I wouldn't respond to her calling out for me, she called the cops. The fire department shows up first and start asking her questions about what happened and all the basics. They decided to do a quick sweep of the house and make sure. Well, one of the firemen seen a little shadow move under the coffee table, me, and asked if my grams had a dog. She didn't. So the search was over, and my grams never wanted to play hide and seek again with me. And that, kids, is how I earned the nickname Heidi. My grandma was Jewish and she was playing hide and seek with her brother as kids. She hid well and was very happy, the thrill of excitement from finding the perfect spot. Nobody would find her there. Then, out of nowhere, a group of Nazi soldiers break in the house. My grandma told me this story and at this point, she starts crying. She told me she couldn't see anything, but she could hear the screams of her own family as they were carried away. Her mother, her father, her brother and her sister were all taken that and she never saw them again. She was left alone in this world. It had truly traumatized her to this day and I wouldn't wish it upon anyone. I was and still am horrified at this story. She was lucky to be alive. Hope you're at peace now, Grandma, rest in peace. I was probably like 12 or 13. And because I was the youngest, my friends would always make me seek. I was counting while leaning on someone's fence. Keep in mind that this was happening in the countryside, in a small village where people know each other. So leaning on someone's fence and playing hide and seek is completely normal. While counting, I could hear my friends yelling, "Flav run, run, behind you, run, Flav run." Of course I ignored them. They used to trick me like this all the time. They would make me look just so I start counting again from zero. Meanwhile I was thinking, "Ha, you are not tricking me this time, losers." The next thing I know, a friend grabs my hand, pulls me like crazy and yells run. When I looked behind me, there was a drunk man, pointing his gun at me. Apparently this girl at first ran away but then she came back to pull me. I don't think the idiot was actually going to shoot me. I think he just wanted to scare all of us because we were allowed. But still, that girl was extremely courageous. One time in June, me and my younger sister, we were around 5 and 10, decided to play hide and seek. Anyway, I was the seeker whilst my sister, let's call her M, went to hide. I looked everywhere and told my mom that she wasn't coming out after I said that I had given up a new win, so it was a search party for this small girl with everyone in the house. As the garden was pretty large and filled with trees, I decided to look there, and as she was little I thought Em might have fallen asleep. My grandparents and my mom got worried and dialed 999, emergency services in UK, and they came to the house and asked what she was seen last in, and they even said they'd release the chopper. So anyway, she was found behind the door in the study and learned a good lesson. TL, doctor, me and sister played hide and seek. She was found by cops behind a door. One of my friends was playing hide and seek in a big group at his place when he was like 13 or 14. Their garage was an absolute mess. Like, completely packed with all sorts of random shit, enough so that you had to walk on top of slash through things, so he decided that it'd be a fantastic place to hide. But just to add another layer of difficulty to it, he decided to hide by laying down on some of the beams above the track for the garage door. At some point he lost his balance and fell about 10 feet down onto a pile of bikes, trash bags full of clothes, car parts, etc. While he was falling, he desperately tried to grab hold of the beam he was on and instead managed to barely reach the track for the garage door. His first finger on his left hand made contact right on the last knuckle before his fingertip, and that portion of the garage door track had a V-shape to it, and severed it cleanly. He landed on the pile of junk bleeding and screaming, and he was rushed to the hospital. Some of his family searched for a while to find his fingertip, hoping the doctors would be able to reattach it, and they found it still cradled in the V-shaped portion of the track. Unfortunately, they didn't know to put it on ice. We sometimes now refer to him as 9¾, since that's how many fingers he has. We used to play a similar game called Sardines, where only one person hides, everyone else seeks him slash her, and when you find the person hiding, you hide with them. The last person to find you all loses. It's hilarious with a group of you trying to cram into some of the tiny hiding spots. My family used to rent a chateau in France every other year for Christmas, so you could get all 16 odd members of my family in one place. It was awesome, and the place was huge, with a wine cellar and three staircases, so there was plenty of places to hide. It was so good we managed to get our grandparents to join in, and one game got pretty competitive that in a mad rush between my granddad and a few of my cousins, managed to fall down the stairs and break his leg. That promptly banned us from playing that for the rest of a holiday.